break. You can blame it on the tech or the disrespect. Before you play, better button check. Button check.
What is up, Button Check family? Welcome back to yet again, a beautiful day, a beautiful morning, well, kinda, of checking these buttons. Thank you guys for tuning in. We took a little day off yesterday, but now we're back and refreshed, and we're back with that sub button right there on the race to 70K. Thank you guys so much for all the love. Of course, chapters down below, we got some bangers. This is the way to return right here, because we got some banger topics, and we got some exciting news coming up next week. But for now, we about to check these buttons. You notice I got the NY hat on, and when you got an NY hat on, I realize you can't wear it like this. You gotta wear it like this. This is the swag, you know what I'm saying? And just so happens, I'm going back to NY next weekend. No, there's not an event or anything. I just love the damn city and I wanna visit. I'm excited. Y'all excited? Let's check these buttons. Let's go. All right, now into them. First set of Tekken players either pissed off or apologizing about Tekken 8 buttons that need to be checked. All right, so this was a hot one. A lot of it just popped off yesterday, right? So apparently Knee, y'all know, holy Knee, right? Information on the screen, link down below. The man's been, you know, playing Tekken and been a god in the game for quite some time, right? Apparently he made a tweet just yesterday to set the FGC on fire. A lot of people agree, right? A lot of people making videos as well, right? Went on to say that he's not enjoying the game. It's not as fun as he would like it to be, and we'll break that down a little bit, right? But before, I think a good video, Spag actually made a good video about this, a content creator, player, I mean, he does it all in the Tekken community, right? Definitely check out Spag, his information down below. We're just gonna check out a clip of this video, and like I said, it goes really in depth on his channel, so check it out. Let's peep it.
It's after the recent ATL tournament, stating that in his opinion, Tekken 8 is not fun. Now, he goes on to say that the aggressive game is actually too absurd right now. And as someone that's been playing the game since Tekken 1, he feels like he just can't understand Tekken 8. Now, there's a lot to unpack here. Now, firstly, you have to understand that Knee is not just a player who's been playing for the past, you know, 10 years or whatever. No, this guy's been playing for decades, right, at the high level, you know. I remember seeing his videos back in Tekken 4, man. And this guy was playing at a super, super high level back then. The highest level. And even at a point where, you know, the Pakistanis, we know them to be probably the best, no, not probably, definitely the best in the game right now. You know, they've won so many titles in Tekken 7. Yep. Who knows who's going to win Tekken 8, but right now they are the best. And they even said that Knee was the reason, one of the reasons why these guys were able to get so good, because they watched his videos back. But he says he can't understand Tekken 8. And, you know, I've got to be very honest with you guys. It is probably because, you know, Knee and Arslan Ash are both very primarily focused on defense more than their offense. And of course, Tekken 8 is an offensive game.
Yeah.
Now, I was at the Tekken World Tour Finals in Amsterdam when Namco first revealed the heat system and the general mechanics of Tekken 8. I was also one of the first guys to actually play the game when Bandai Namco Europe invited me down to their office over a year ago. And that's why I was able to make that overview video of Tekken 8. As soon as I got to play the game, the first thing I thought in my head was, this is not a game which is going to suit Knee or Arslan Ash. I mean, these guys are so primarily focused on defense, as I said, and both have shown over their many, many years of competing that, you know, defense is actually what wins tournaments. And it's one of the reasons why I was saying for years, the reason why Rangchu was able to win the Tekken World Tour Finals in 2018 with Panda is because of his strong defense.
Okay, so there you have it, man. Spag breaking it down. Like I said, definitely check out his channel, man. He does awesome work. He also did another follow-up video. I think this is important. We're going to show a small clip of this one where he got to interview a lot of the Tekken pros, namely Arslan Ash, because Arslan also made a tweet, which we made a video about, right, some weeks ago, where he was like, heat system, all this other stuff. What's the point? Why do they even give him, like, regular moves? Something to that effect, right? He actually asked Arslan, he puts him on the spot in a way, saying, why did you tweet this, right? They're all friends at the end of the day. Arslan actually responds. It's interesting, right? Let's check it out.
A tweet made by our very own Arslan Ash. Tekken 8 be like, heat burst, heat smash, power crushes, heat engages, throws. That's it. Seriously, why did they even bother giving each character a variety of moves? Hashtag Tekken 8. Now, the reason why I showed this tweet,
he's like, oh shit, that's, yeah,
is because of something that actually me and Speakers were talking about.
I think my take, why I wrote that. I think my take was, okay, so I think all of us have been playing, I don't know about Super Akuma, but I know about, like, Speedy, Joe Fury, and him. We have been playing from, when I'm fighting recent newcomers, you know, and new players in Tekken 8, What they're doing is they're gonna power crushes, heat smashes, down back force, and then power crush again into heat engager. I think this is not good. This is not Tekken. This is not what we used to play. I am just against, I think, this idea. And this is why I did post. And I know that a lot of people are saying, even Joka is saying it's like vanilla version, they're gonna fix it. But I think the direction they are going, I don't like it. Like they are just adding heat engagers, like heat and other stuff, heat burst, heat engager, heat smash. Like the whole idea, I don't like it. It's like the game is for like noobs at the moment. It feels like it's not for like competitive players. Like this is what I'm gonna say.
Damn, you said it's like for noobs, right? People were responding to Knee's initial post, right? I even see LTG saying, ha ha, thank you. Other people are like, it's frustrating to play, but it's fun for people to watch in big tournaments because lots of action. I think Namco wants the game to attract people this way. Others are like, more fun than T7 for casual players equals millions of players. It's good to see Tekken Dev decide to make a real fun game for casuals, not pros. Making it for pros was a moronic idea in the beginning. Some players think a balanced game equals a fun, but nope. We played many but unbalanced games before. T7 balanced but no fun game at the end. Poke all day, guard all day, bye bye Kansas. Damn, that's an interesting point of view, right? Saying that balance doesn't necessarily equal fun, right? Others are like, what are you talking about, millions of players? Do you even look at the data before you make such absurd claims? The player base has been in a decline since the release. Probably won't stop until it settles about 5,000 or 6,000 players at a 24-hour peak. Casuals never stick to fighting games, so catering to them is a massive mistake in the longevity, or you want longevity. So damn, that's an interesting take. So on one hand, you got people saying, well, Bandai did it on purpose, right? Because they want to sell more, they want to make it fun. Catering to the pros, let's be real. If you're in the FGC, especially if you're on FGC Twitter and all that, if you keep up with it, chances are you're not a casual, right? It's more than a hobby at this point. Not to say that you're a pro, but you're not a casual, right? So anyway, they're saying catering, let's break it down this way. Catering to us is a moronic idea because technically, in the scheme of things, we're the minority, right? There's more casuals out there than there are I can't even fucking talk. Diehard fans or FGC members, right? I think that's what he's trying to say. So he's also saying balanced doesn't automatically equal a successful game or a fun game. But on the other hand, you see that person responding back saying, what the fuck you talking about? The numbers are declining and casuals are a mistake because they drop off faster than anybody else. And in the end of a game, you want longevity. Two sides of that argument, man. How y'all feeling about that? But then it comes full circle because just a few hours ago today, Knee was like, you know what? I'm sorry. He was like, rethought some things, right? And he just posted this. So this is right here is basically an update to all the videos that's been posted on yesterday or earlier today, right? Because Knee just posted this one right here. Let's get it. Saying, I didn't expect my opinion to be such a big topic. It's been 3 months since it was released. Honestly, you guys all know, found out the depths of Tekken 8. I think T8 made learn quickly. This means something different from knowing to beat your opponent. The reason I said it wasn't fun was when I realized the legacy knowledge and strategies I learned from playing Tekken a long time weren't working, right? He continues right here, getting a little deeper below. And that's interesting that he said that, right? Because he's like, all my knowledge is not working. And you gotta understand, that's probably hard for a pro to wrap their head around, right? But anyway, right here he says, because there is only reward in attack and no reward in defense. If you block, you've lost health. This is a new era of Tekken I probably haven't adapted. This may be the trend of gaming these days. Maybe I'm an old person, haha. Some will like it, some won't. I think it's very hard to make the game satisfies everyone. I'm not going to ask BN to change the game to good pro level players. Tekken 8 can be a very good game with little modified. It may be negative to look at it as a legacy player, but I think I should try to adapt to the new meta. Maybe enjoy T8. I will try hard because I really like Tekken. Sorry for the negative opinion as it's just been released. Damn. There you have it. You can see it was posted today. And he's like, yo, I'm just tired of this. I'm gonna try. FGC is responding, mixed emotions, right? Mixed reactions. You got PL saying, Knee, don't apologize. It's your opinion. It is valid. I see Big Bird saying, don't be sorry for sharing your opinion about the game. Your opinion matters and your experience is very thoughtful, right? Ryan Hart says, you are more than welcome to share your opinion. Whatever it is, developers need to understand how people experience their products too, especially as someone who has played every Tekken. Those thoughts are extremely valuable, right? keep on doing what you do. Others finishing it up right here saying, don't forget, you're the GOAT of Tekken. Tekken is not Tekken without Ni. So everyone sees your opinion as very important. You said right, it's a new game and we have to learn new things. Maybe it can be fun if you think of it as a new challenge. Much to learn, but you can do it, damn. And not only that, but fucking Arslan Ash comes around. You know Arslan's been very outspoken since the beginning, saying he didn't either get it, he didn't understand it, or he didn't like it, right? We just saw a clip of him saying that, right? That he felt it was basically built for noobs. Well, looks like pigs done flew as well, because Arslan Ash is like, you know what? I'm done. I'm just gonna play the game and I'm gonna adapt. He posted this just today as well, right? Saying, I'm tired of complaining about the game. I'm just going to adapt regardless of the meta. I'll find my character and my style. You'll see me at the top soon. Bam. So it looks like the pros are finally coming around, right? Well, at least some of them, right? Sonic saying, we're space control specialists. It's just so incredibly hard to control the chaos in this game. We must simply play something incredibly oppressive. Others adding, saying, you got this, or, you know, wish you the best, or that's right, you've chosen to take it to the next level, and you have gained even more mental strength. A lot of people just appreciating those words, and there you have it. So, we know Tekken 8 has been in a weird place. There's a lot of things that are continuing to go on with it. Some people think it was just like a stage of MK1, but at the same time, obviously, as you can see, some people always thought that, no, it just takes some understanding, or it's fun. Maybe not be fun for you pros or what you're expecting, but for the casuals, it's a good game. Matter of fact, we think it's the best version of this yet. But also, you got Ni and Arslan finally coming around, and they finally changing their mind. Like, you know what? We're some of the best. Basically, in a nutshell, they're saying we need to stop making excuses, and we need to adapt. How y'all feeling about that? Let me know. All right, next up for them MK1 leak buttons that need to be checked. This one popped off the other day, right? I'm sure a lot of you already know by this, but apparently there was a voice actress. I guess she does the voice of, I don't know the character's name yet. I just fucking forgot it, right? We'll find out right now. It's on the screen. Scorpion's fucking wife. I didn't even know he had a wife. You know what I'm saying? They're going to put her in the game. It's like the female version of Scorpion. Well, I don't even know why I'm saying this. We're about to unpack it. Either way, look, there's a YouTuber by the name of Dynasty that did a really good clip of this. I think he did it just yesterday. We'll check out a small clip. Definitely check out his channel. Link down below. So we'll check out that clip and then we'll unpack it. Let's go.
Why am I talking through a phone? She typed out, hey, I'm gonna be a roomie. Mortal Kombat 1, cameo fighter. And, that post was quickly deleted within a few hours, which led many to think that, well, somebody probably let her know, like, you weren't supposed to do that because it's not been made official yet. So in today's video, doing a deep dive into this entire situation, you guys obviously do know that over the past 8-9 months, we've essentially got the upcoming two DLC packs, both the expansion and KP2, data mined via the game source code from the Thinny, from Inner Loco. But when it came to cameo fighters, we really haven't gotten anything too concrete outside of a few names that are from the main roster that get featured as cameo fighters. We're not actually sure if that's from like a story mode or an expansion and not an actual like fully fledged standalone cameo fighter on that select screen playable in the game, the core gameplay. But regardless, talking about this today, we'll see what we can unpack if you guys are excited for Harumi. The idea that you can have Scorpion and his wife for the first time ever as a fucking tag team in a Mortal Kombat game, which I think is kind of sweet. Do me a solid, please take a second, drop a like on the video. How are you guys enjoying Ermac? It seems like universal.
All right, so definitely check out his channel, right? Link down below. But this is the tweet that everybody's talking about. I was tagged in it yesterday. Big up to Les Kid for tagging me, man, saying cameo leak. I appreciate the love, homie. So this is the tweet right here. Somebody was saying, y'all, I don't think she was supposed to say all that. So the voice actress posted this on Instagram, bless her heart, right? She was so excited. She was like, hey, everybody, I'm so happy to announce this, basically, right? You can say, pinch me. I've been bursting to share that I am the face of Harumi in the new Mortal Kombat. Absolutely honored to be a part of this legendary game as the female playable version of Scorpion. Plot timeline twist, I love, thank you. She tags everybody. NetherRealm, Warner Brothers, I mean, she tags everybody that's saying, make sure to pick up MK1, pick Harumi as your cameo mom, dad. I'm a badass character, kicking ass and defeating evil. I made it. Oh my God, bless her heart. How are you gonna, I'm confused, because obviously this wasn't a leak. I mean, technically, yes. But she said it, like, she obviously thought that it was time. Maybe she marked her fucking calendar. The alarm clock don't went off too soon. But she tagged everybody. She tagged mom and dad, my third grade teacher. She tagging everybody thinking she had the green light and then deleted. Fuck. What a way. You know, she's talking about this is my dream. I've been waiting for this. Like, look at me now. And everybody's like, get the fuck, sit your ass down, girl. Damn, what a way. She must be kicking herself. But look, as long as the character's cool, I mean, look, at the end of the day, you did your thing. You're still in the game. It might have been a little fuck up right here, but look, voice actress, you're still in the game. You still did your damn thing. And I think ultimately, I mean, some people were already talking about this character. I saw videos a few months ago where people were thinking this character, you know, was going to be in here as a cameo. But, you know, if it makes MK1 better, we all know, Lord knows, the MK1 could use all the help it could get. Some people still rocking with it. We'll see how it does. But in the meantime, we got a leak. And this is a hell of a leak. You got to feel for the voice actors. But either way, there it is. How y'all feel it? Let me know. There it is one more time. Thank you guys for all the amazing love. We will see you soon, if not tomorrow, definitely the next day. All the information down below. Got some giveaways at the end of the month. And like I said, I'm going to NY. I love it. NY, I'm from Cali, if you don't know. I've been in Texas, Dallas, for like the last 2 decades, right? But I consider New York like my third home. I fucking love that place, you know what I'm saying? So I like to go to New York at least 2 times a year. One for just like casual, and then one for tournaments or stuff like that. So this will just be casual. Anyway, holler at me if you happen to be in that NY. And I love you guys, and we'll see you soon. Thank you guys for amazing love. As always, I don't know what it is, but I know it is Thursday. It's about to get better. Peace.
Blah, blah, blah. Subscribe.
So you can. I kind of feel it's like this for the Tekken players, right? It's like they don't really love T8, but they done already got the bitch pregnant. You know what I'm saying? They got Tekken pregnant because they've been messing with her for so damn long. And they're like, you know what? I'm going to do it for the baby. I'm going to do it for the baby because my mama done told me to do the right thing and my pastor told me to. I'm going to get in a relationship. You know, I'm going to give it a chance. I'm going to, you know what? I'm going to adapt to the meta. I'm gonna adapt to the meta and I'm gonna give this bitch a chance even though she get on my nerves and it was kind of a one night stand, but you know what, I'm gonna give you a chance because of the baby. And then you get in there and then you move in and then 2 months go by, you go, holy, I can't stand this bitch. And then some more time passes and the child gets about 2 years old and you realize, you know what, I think I'm gonna be a single parent. And inevitably you pull back again because it simply wasn't meant to be. That's how I kind of see it for these T8 pros. And why do I see it that way? Do I speak from personal experience? Nah, me? Nah, not Nesto. Not Nesto, Nesto, no. Not Nesto. My pullout game is, my pullout, man. Mine? Woo! It's non-existent. It doesn't exist.